My name is Gabby Bailato. I'm a solutions marketing engineer here with Keysight Technologies. Today we will capture a pulsed radar signal using a real-time spectrum analyzer. We'll use the dual digitizer architecture to capture both time and frequency domains simultaneously. Here's a view of the spectrogram and powergram mode in the real-time spectrum analyzer. The left-hand side is the frequency domain of the pulsed radar signal, and the spectrogram view shows power versus frequency over time. Similarly, we also have the time domain view here on the right with power versus time and the power versus time over time in the powergram. Notice that you can clearly see the pulse signal in the time domain view, but it's almost impossible to tell that we have a pulse signal in the frequency domain. This is because currently we are capturing the signal with a wide acquisition bandwidth. It gives us good resolution in the time domain, but in order to understand the signal in the frequency domain, we'll need to narrow the span. First, let's change the span down to 10 MHz. You can now see that the signal is a pulse signal in the frequency domain, but we are starting to lose resolution in the time domain view. Let's adjust the span even further down to 1 MHz. Now we can clearly see the pulse line spectrum, but the resolution isn't great for timing measurements. With traditional real-time spectrum analyzers, you would have to make measurements with this trade-off of either good frequency resolution and poor timing resolution, or vice versa. But with the architecture of this analyzer, we can use two 255 MHz digitizers to adjust the time and frequency acquisition independently of each other. By using the dual domain architecture of the analyzer, you can now see that I can increase the acquisition bandwidth of my time domain measurement to 255 MHz, and I can leave the frequency domain at 1 MHz. Now we can restart the measurement, and lower the acquisition time so that we can fully zoom in on the pulse signal. We now have a very clear picture of our signal under test, and we have good resolution in both domains. This is a very simple example of a radar signal. Many times, electronic warfare engineers need to verify that their system under test is working as expected. I'll now add another signal into the spectrum, which will simulate a jammer signal. We can still see the original radar signal, and we can also now see the jammer signal, which has a higher power level. Also notice that the jammer signal is changing PRIs relative to the radar signal. This is a range gate pull-off technique, which is used to make the radar believe that the threat is moving away from it. The powergram is also a good representation of the trend of the jammer over time. Another technique that the jammer threat will use is a Doppler frequency shift to simulate change in velocity. It is a very subtle change, so we will need to narrow the span in the frequency domain to see it. I'll go ahead and change the frequency span down to 20 kHz. You can now see that the radar's main tone is at 4 GHz and that there is a slight Doppler shift on the jammer. I'll go ahead and pause the measurement and use the markers to measure this Doppler shift. By enabling a delta marker, we can move it over to the end of the frequency change. Which tells us that there's about a 10 kHz frequency shift. We can clearly now see what the trend of our jammer signal is. Without the dual domain architecture of the UXA signal analyzer, measurements in time and frequency domain would not show both of the shifts with such good resolution. It's a powerful tool for applications like the one shown today and many other signals from systems under test in electronic warfare. For more information, please visit keysight.com or contact your local Keysight representative. Thanks for listening.